Good evening, TheoTrade. This is Corey Rosenblum, and you're watching the Theo Nightly video for the 5th of August in 2021. And we have a sneak move, sneak attack to a new all-time high, but a new all-time high it was. And in the spiders, which is our ETF, that snuck its way to an all-time high. And beyond the S&P, we have the NASDAQ, and that's still a sneaker. All-time high it is, and the bull market continues. The pattern will change, but it will change when the pattern reverses. And reverse meaning lower low and lower high. But until that point, we still continue to have, in terms of the trend structure, all these things are higher highs and higher lows in price. And we connect the dots, and that gives us a rising uptrend. And that's where we have the market. For the NASDAQ, again, that same level took place. We see that in the NASDAQ futures and in the tradable QQQ, which is our ETF. Again, the options or the sold premium or the purchase calls or different hedging strategies can be easily done within the spiders, Qs, or other ETFs, which includes the IWM, and that's the Russell ETF. As I'm slightly joking about the all-time highs, the sneak attack to all-time highs, the Russell isn't doing that, and the Dow is not either. And it is just, again, slightly beneath it, but slightly beneath it it is. I want to focus on the Russell. And starting with the IWM, we continue to have a trading range. And that trading range is a sideways line or a rectangle or just range contraction. This phase is called range expansion. And this phase is called range contraction. And this is easy to see on the Russell. Not as easy in other stocks. One stock that does have a similar pattern and similar structure is actually Amazon. And despite the bullish headlines and the bullish earnings, we are seeing Amazon back within the box. And the box is simply 3500 to about 3000, a little bit beyond those boundaries for the spikes, but nonetheless, consolidation, chop, and sideways action it is. And Apple has a slight bend to that side as well. I would say that Apple has more of a sideways trading range. Yes, it is ascending. Yes, it's going up, but it's not trending. So compare this, which is more of a creep or box or range style rally. And notice the little consolidation in Apple shares on the hourly chart. Compare this with something like Target. Target is a prevailing and dominant uptrend. And we don't use the word bull market for a stock. Again, I don't buy into those terminologies, but higher high, higher low, higher high, higher low, higher high, up, lower low, but a lower low does not reverse the trend. Higher high, higher low, and we still continue this pattern. And this is one of those strong trend patterns that I like to play bull flags or play call spreads or some type of purchase premium to the upside. And these are strong stocks getting stronger. We'll actually start today's video, or the middle part of today's video, with stocks making new 52-week highs. And that's the pattern of strength. And the concept is that which is strong tends to get a little stronger. And that is due in part to fundamentals and the broad narrative and the bigger picture and the trends in money flow and products and management and all those things on the fundamental side, but also on the technical side. Technical just means the charts. And again, something as simple as higher highs, higher lows is sufficient to frame out short-term trades. And these stocks are nothing more than a scan for those making. We'll highlight how the scan takes place. We just go to load scan query. And for me, it's the public list, new yearly highs. And I filter that or scan in the S&P 500. In today's session of the 500 or so stocks in the S&P, 50 of them, 51 to be exact, made new 52-week highs. In some cases, they are all-time highs. In this case, about 10% of the market of the S&P stocks are making 52-week highs. And that is not necessarily a measure of strength in the bull or the broader market, but just a note of what is outperforming the market. And those stocks that tend to outperform the market continue, usually, to outperform the market, just to name a few. And we'll put this on the weekly chart to the right. But that's what gives edge, at least for me and my perspective, of getting buys, pullbacks, or trading in the direction of a trend, of course, until that trend reverses. And Target is just one of these names. The others would include Adobe, and of course these are sorted on my list by market cap. So I will not look at all of the stocks. I will just focus on market cap names that are usually above, closer to the 100 or 90 or 100 million, or essentially 100 billion dollar range. That's market cap centric. And there's Adobe. Nike continues to make that list. There are no buys in here, just for reference. Why I showed these candidates are to put into a watch list or to put on candidates or write them down or keep them on a daily or weekly basis for future pullbacks. There is no way to get long at these highs. That is a very poor risk-reward opportunity. And the better opportunity is, of course, buy on the pullbacks, retracements, or flags, but just getting these into a list is sufficient. And these stocks continue to make new highs. Danaher is up next. That is a weekly chart trend here and a daily chart trend there. Moving averages, by the way, are guides. They are not necessarily predictive at all. Costco, which still continues to surprise even me, still manages to prevail to the upside despite a very weak start to 2021. It makes 52-week highs currently. Intuit, which is another stock that has relatively stable uptrends. What I am looking for are stable pullbacks to get long, and there are no stable pullbacks here. This is a runaway trend that is mainly good for studying, but wait for those pullbacks. This is difficult to get long and even more perilous to get short. These runaway, the gate has opened and the train has left the station, these sort of things, they become difficult. You probably want to focus on short selling other stocks for easier pullbacks. And those would be stocks in trading ranges, which would be none of the ones making 52-week highs. Intuitive Surgical just pushed above the 1,000 per share print. And that continues a prevailing uptrend. And you see the COVID lows. If you're looking at how these stocks have performed, that is the COVID lows, which was about March or April of 2020. A year has come and gone, and stocks have well exceeded their pre-pandemic or pre-lockdown highs. And that's one quick way to reference a big event on the market. And others would include Chipotle Mexican Grill, which we lovingly call the expensive burrito. In this case, it is a $1,900 burrito. But burrito it is, restaurant it is, and up at these high levels it is. It doesn't have to make sense, it doesn't make sense, but nevertheless, Chipotle does scan or come up on that scan. Of course, other stocks do as well. And outside the equity market, we can take a quick look as we conclude tonight's video on crude oil, which had its own rally. And if you remember during the pandemic, the worst of the pandemic, not the rolling contract, but one of the front month contracts at expiration actually went negative. And we would think that could never happen, but it did. But the rolling contract stayed positive. But that is a print at $5 per barrel for crude oil. And that was at the pandemic low. And that has since recovered to 75, but it has done so in a strong uptrend. And again, that has done so similarly to the S&P. And that's your S&P right there. So keep that in mind with the uptrend, the higher highs, higher lows. And we'll actually decouple these and we'll leave us to the studying. And then tomorrow will be very important. Tomorrow will be the jobs report. That will happen pre-market. We had a little weaker than expected pre-jobs report, if you will, earlier in the week, but nonetheless, did not matter. Market is sneaking its way to all-time highs. But just to conclude, crude oil on the right, S&P on the left, these are positively correlated. And so as crude does well, I'll highlight this at the end of the video. Although the S&P is at all-time highs, crude is getting a pullback, retracement, or sell swing. So they have decoupled just a little bit from these highs. As always, be careful and safe. This is Corey Rosenblum with tonight's Theo video update for August 5th, 2021.